but there are curses through bloodline. If someone has a curse, give me some examples of what might be a tip-off there's a curse operating
in
their life.
Well, the first thing that I think a curse does is it creates wrong mindsets. In other words, we think incorrectly about ourselves. Maybe because there's a curse of poverty in a family line, they think with a poverty mentality. They don't believe God wants them to prosper. And or there's sickness in that bloodline, or there's depression in that bloodline, or there's anger issues in that bloodline. It fashions and forms the way we see ourselves. And so one of the first things that a curse does is it creates a mindset. And when that curse is broken or is removed, then we're able to come free of that wrong thinking.
Give me your definition of a curse.
Well, I call a curse a spiritual force that will sabotage our future and our success. I mean, I don't know how many times I lived my life before I discovered this, that it would seem like I would be on the brink of a breakthrough only for it not to happen. And I would see this pattern repeat itself over and over. And that's always a sign of a curse, a repetition of a pattern over and over and over. Whatever it may be, there is a curse that's operating in that situation. The Bible says in Proverbs 26:2, a curse without a cause cannot land. It says it's like birds flying around looking for a place to land. So it says a curse has to have a cause. That word cause, it would imply that it has found a legal right to operate against this bloodline. And that's why you see certain types of attitudes, behaviors, sicknesses, and depressions, or whatever, being passed from generation to generation, never able to come into the destiny ordained by God.
Briefly, you had a curse in your bloodline that if it hadn't been dealt with, the devil would have stopped you from sitting right in that chair today.
Absolutely. I mean, I realized that timidity was a curse. It was in my family line. My dad was very timid. My oldest sister was very timid and on back. I was so timid that when my wife and I were dating, she would have to order for me. She would have to talk to
the waiter or waitress.
I know. She would have to talk to the waiter or waitress for me because I was so bashful and timid and not wanting to do that. And so I realized that I used to think, well, that's just a personality trait. No, that's a curse. If that hadn't have broken, I would not be able to be a minister, a spokesman.
You would not have achieved your destiny.
That's right.